we've done some data analysis, of course, and it's showing some positive trends in a couple of ways. We are improving the amount of reporting, which we take as a nice compliment from the community that they have trust in the police department that will handle their case and handle it well. So an increase in reporting, it's important to point out, does not necessarily reflect an increase in crime. Sexual violence is clearly one of the most underreported crimes, and so we know that there's a lot of victims in the past that had not reported. And so we feel good that we're getting them to come in the door and talk to us about it, but it does not reflect an increase in sexual violence in Missoula. Another nice thing that our data analysis has brought forward is that we're keeping more of these victims engaged through the process. It's not uncommon at all for victims to initially report and then feel kind of overwhelmed or intimidated by the process going forward. Criminal justice system can be difficult to navigate through, and so keeping victims engaged in the process as their case is investigated is something we've been working to do, and we're doing a better job of that now. So we have a compliance graph that's included in the report, and there is 24 categories that we're working towards compliance on. Of the 24, we have met compliance status in 19 of those categories. So of the remaining 5 categories, they really can be summed up into three big kind of areas. And one is continued data analysis, collection analysis. And the other two are two projects that are underway, which is the victim and advocate surveys and the safety and accountability audit. So as we move towards the spring, my focus will be really crunching those numbers in our data analysis and making sure that the survey, which is already live, that it continues to go forward. We pull information back from victims and advocates about how we're doing, and getting that safety and accountability wrapped up, which, again, is well underway. I would say we're over halfway done with that, and that will put us in good shape heading towards, May and June, when we're hoping to be out of the agreement.
Yeah, I was going to ask you a little bit about the time frame involved here. This was a 3-year agreement, right?
2 years. So we signed an agreement May 15th, 2013. Okay. So we want to be compliant in all categories by May of 2014.
All right. So now after that...
I'm sorry, May of 2015.
After that is done, Mike, then what? Is it simply a matter of maintenance, or will the Department of Justice be checking back or calling, or do you know yet?
No, they wouldn't have. Once we're out of the agreement, there's nothing in place that keeps them, with any type of oversight of the department. So your reference there to maintenance is exactly right. We're not going to just undo everything we've done in the last 2 years because we have no further oversight. I expect it will keep the vast majority of all of our things that we're doing now in place going forward. It makes no sense to go through all of this stuff and then turn around and scrap it as soon as we're out of oversight.